Hello students, one child, one teacher, one book, one pen. This is our second lesson in English class 7. It is an extract from the book I Am Malala. The book is about a girl Malala who was shot by the Taliban for standing up in favor of girls' education. Presently, Malala works as an activist for female education and is also the winner of Nobel Peace Prize 2014. In this particular extract, Malala talks about how much her life has changed since she left her country, Pakistan. After Malala's recovery, she and her family have shifted to the UK. Their lifestyle here is completely different. She tells, though her house is quite big, it feels like they are in a luxury house arrest, a kind of a jail. The neighbors are just a walk's distance from their house, but it feels they are miles away. This is because there is no communication between them and then they don't even meet. But there is something that has not changed much in their lives. It is the food. Malala tells us the food that they eat here is much the same as they used to have when they were in Pakistan. The same rice and meat for lunch and dinner, while fried eggs and chapatis in breakfast. She also recalls her house in Mingora. Students, Mingora is the place in Pakistan where Malala hails from. Her house would always be full of people like her neighbors and relatives whenever she returned home from school. And sometimes she even had to pray to God. For one day of peace and some privacy to do her schoolwork. Malala's mother was very sociable back then, but now she doesn't have anyone to chat with as she does not speak English, and so she is always on the phone talking with her friends and relatives in Mingora. Malala also tells how her new house has all the facilities, but they hardly know how to use them, such as oven, washing machine and the television. There are buses and trains too, but again they are unsure about using them. But the worst thing that they face there in the UK is fear. Malala's mother shakes with fear as soon as she hears the door bang. Even her father cries when he sees the scar on her head. He holds himself responsible for Malala getting shot by the Taliban. He thinks he pushed her to speak up for girl education in their country. But no, Malala admits it was not his fault, for she understands how much efforts her father has put in trying to educate kids, including girls. He had even built a college, and worked there for almost 20 years in providing education to all the children. His dream was to have a very big school in Swat, providing quality education to live peacefully and to have democracy in their country. But everything is just left behind. Now he spends much of his time in going to conferences on education, and he feels very proud to be known by his daughter. He feels that he is lucky when people call him Malala's father. Further, Malala tells us about her 16th birthday, where she was in New York to speak at the UN, addressing a huge audience in the hall. Her speech not only addressed the UN delegates, but every single person around the world who could make a difference. through her speech, she wanted to reach people living in poverty and misery. Malala later went on to call on the world's leaders to provide free education to every child in the world. With this, we come to an end of one more lesson. Students, do comment if any queries regarding the lesson. Thank you.